Our transformative agenda is unstoppable. The journey to self-sufficiency, competitiveness, and prosperity today receives further impetus. Today, Kenya welcomes 140 megawatts into the national grid. This is the story of Olkaria 4. Construction work began in 2012, involving Kenjin, Hyundai of Korea, Toyota Tsusho of Japan, and a consortium bringing together Sinopec of China and KEC of India. The 140 megawatt Olkaria 4 geothermal power is part of a larger project designed to deliver 280 megawatts to the national grid by the end of this year. The project comprises Olkaria 4 with an output of 140 megawatts and Olkaria 1 units 4 and 5 with a combined capacity of 140 megawatts. The 280 megawatts is the largest single geothermal power project of its kind in the world and firmly cements Kenya's credentials as one of the global leaders in the development of this renewable form of energy. Olkaria 4 power plant has two steam turbine generators. Each of the turbines generates 70 megawatts, hence giving a total of 140 megawatts for the whole plant. Each turbine uses 485 tons per hour of steam to generate power and rotates at a speed of 3000 rotations per minute. Steam entering the turbine is at high pressure and temperature, more than 150 degrees Celsius. Steam gets into the power plant through the ground floor, then is piped upwards to the turbine floor via the mezzanine floor. The condenser for each steam turbine is located on the ground floor. The main steam strainers are located on the mezzanine floor. Also located here are the steam control valves. Once the steam has rotated the turbine, it condenses and falls onto the condenser. From the condenser, the condensed steam is pumped out to the cooling towers as very hot water. The plant has two cooling towers, one for each unit. A cooling tower is essentially a heat exchanger. There are 8 cells in each cooling tower. Each cooling tower cell has a motorized cooling fan to aid in the heat exchange by forced aeration. Hot water from the condenser is pumped into the cooling tower, where it enters from the top and trickles down to the basin. As the water trickles down, it is dispersed by the cooling tower fills while the fans sucks the air upwards. This way, the water is cooled. Each steam turbine generator has a 90 megavolt ampere or 220 kilovolt setup transformer for evacuating the generated power through transmission lines. There are also some auxiliary transformers for steam field and house load supplies. The plant is fitted with two steam scrubbers. The purpose of the steam scrubbers is to ensure the steam entering the turbines is 99.99% dry steam. That is, removes any wetness in the steam for maximum conversion. The plant utility shelter houses the water treatment facility. Here, there is a raw water treatment for supply of potable water to the plant. In here, we also house firefighting facilities. At its every stage, this project was designed to make history. The program of commissioning large-scale power generation facilities is therefore directly connected with the transformative agenda. It is part of the greater freedom struggle narrative. Freedom from poverty, freedom from illiteracy, freedom from sickness, and freedom from hunger. Welcome to Olkaria. Welcome to the future of Kenya. We are now powering our freedom.